Do you know who's going to be the next mayor of Annapolis? None of us do, as the ballot counting continues tonight.
The contest between incumbent Josh Cohen and Republican challenger Mike Pantelides has come down to some 400 absentee and provisional ballots. 11 News reporter Kate Amar is in Annapolis, and she has an update for us.
12 hours into the official canvass, the room got testy.
Those box.
Count the box.
Count the box.
Because it was clear, the official end of the vote counting likely won't end the battle to become mayor of Annapolis. This race is destined for a courtroom.
I was prepared for a victory speech. I was prepared for a concession speech. I wasn't prepared for this.
After revising voting machine numbers, Republican challenger Mike Pantelides was now leading Democratic incumbent Josh Cohen by just 82 votes. With the gap between candidates shrinking, elections officials and campaign reps then agonized over the 416 outstanding absentee and provisional ballots that could still be counted.
I know it's been a slow, arduous process.
A process which came to a grinding halt for hours as the stakeholders debated how to preserve ballots that may be second-guessed in legal proceedings.
In an election obviously this close, under 100 votes, everybody wants to make sure, and we're here for the Cohen campaign to make sure that every vote is counted and counted properly.
The biggest issue overall, nearly 200 absentee ballots that were hand-delivered to the elections office but never time or date stamped. The board decided they would count those votes after nearly 4 hours of debate.
I think it's a great thing. If you're going to do the process, make sure it's open and transparent and it's done right. I'd rather it take 2 days than to rush it in 20 minutes.
That was Kate Amaro reporting from Annapolis.